New users of iMovie may not be aware of how simple it is to add transitions to your edit. However, even frequent users will not be aware of all of the implications of using transitions. In this video, I'll show you the simple ways to use transitions, as well as the ultimate guide to ways you never thought to use them in iMovie, even the ability to use any clip as a transition. iMovie allows for a quick addition of transitions to your edits, but what exactly are transitions for? A transition is a way to ease the jump from one clip to another, and there are two types of transitions. First, those that try to hide the jump from one clip to another, and secondly, the transitions that advertise the change between those two clips. The first hide type is restricted to the first four choices that iMovie offers you. That's cross dissolve, cross blur, fade to black, and fade to white. All the other transitions fall into the second advertiser category. You use the first four to ease the change. You use the other transitions to promote the start of something new or to highlight something you want your viewer to see. So let's start with the simple ways to add. If you want to skip this section to see the other more advanced techniques, look at the timestamps below to jump to the advanced section. Transitions can only be placed between clips in the timeline. You find them in the Transitions tab above the browser. You drag them to the gap between clips. And you can change the type of transition by dragging another inside the transition already in the timeline. You can change the length of the transition by double-clicking it and setting a duration. Click Apply to set the length. But be careful about apply all, as it changes all the other transitions currently in the timeline, not just the new length, but also whatever the transition effect was that you applied. In this case, all the transitions currently in the timeline will be changed to circle open and 1 second in length. I said you can only drag between clips. Well, that's not exactly true. Consider this. If you split a clip, it now becomes two clips, so you can put a transition between them. Press Command plus B or right click, select Split. If you right click again, you can add the default transition, cross dissolve. And that's it for the simple use of transitions in iMovie. There are some secrets about transitions that not all iMovie users will be aware of, particularly when using connected clips. All cutaways, selected in the toolbar, can be faded. There are dots at the top of the cutaway in the timeline. They move together, and they're also controlled in the toolbar with the fade button. Green and blue screen can also have simple fades by sliding those dots. If you split screen a connected clip, it can slide from left, right, top or bottom, and it's controlled by the slider button. Picture in Picture has more choices of transitions. You can dissolve, you can zoom from the top, or swap by showing the connected clip, which zooms the clip in the main timeline to a picture-in-picture size and back. And here's a cool effect for long clips. If you want to add something to a boring clip, consider adding a long transition to signify the passing of time, which will break up that monopoly. But only certain transitions are suitable to be used here. And ripple, put in 5 seconds. And finally, I'll show you how to make transitions from any clip in your timeline. The concept is to make the clip you want to use as short as possible and put a cross dissolve on either side of it to give the illusion of a transition between the two main clips. The short clip gives an impression that it's a transition, and the cross dissolves just add to the illusion. Start by adding a cross dissolve between the two main clips. Shorten it to 0.2 of a second. Drag the short clip you want to use as the transition to the right, hold the Option key and drag a copy of the cross dissolve that's already in the timeline to the right of the transition clip. Play and adjust the transition clip to a suitable length. Making a transition using an animated background. You can get a different animated effect by using one of iMovie's backgrounds as a connected clip and fading either side, as well as using a standard cross dissolve underneath it. Drag a background as a connected clip above the main storyline at an edit point. I'll use the diagonal lines background as it's got a good animation effect. Shorten the clip and add a cross dissolve transition, and you can adjust the opacity to enhance the illusion. You can also adjust the color effect with the toolbar. Also, add more effects to it using the clip filters. And these are some other backgrounds you could use. And you can use any clip in the same way as a transition, even a still image. If you'd like transitions to be even more believable, you can add them to the Keynote application, which will allow you to make them into transitions. And if you'd like to see how to do that, let me know in the comments and I'll produce a video to show you how it's done. That's everything about transitions at iMovie, and I trust you've learned something that you didn't already know. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell to be notified of new videos every Sunday.